Just turned on the light, so I got the hens and the cockerels out from here. The Urban Quail Ranch, put some fresh water. I filled up this water, gave them grit. They've got food, and I'll fill that one up too. Now, what I'm going to do is just pull up the brooder walls. I gotta take that whole thing out and like let them walk away. And then take it out and clean it. Well, maybe they're just gonna go out themselves. So, I wonder how, if I can just tip it off. Well, I think because they are flyers. Yeah, there you go. All right. I was gonna just lift it up, but some of them beat me to it. I just want to close this because, there, oh, they're all coming out. Come on out then. Three of them are out. You gonna come out? They were just sitting around. It's later in the day and I wanted to do it late in the day. Oh, they're listening to me. You're listening to me? So, let's see if I can just take the ends of this. It's pretty light. And lift it up. There. Now they have a larger area. And as soon as they come off of there, I'll just clean it up. Just pick up the fabric and then I'll put some fresh aspen shavings around on the bottom. These ones are like, oh, what in the world just happened? You got a larger world now. Okay, and you guys came out first, did you? Alright, so, put this down for a second. They're safe in here, they don't really need the light anymore, and they've got the light from the outside. This should be off, this other light here should be off for the night. I just want them in a larger area, because you're a little bit big now, aren't you big? I'll take all that stuff out and clean it. What happened to you? You were the first. Turned out with the first group of 12, there was 7 hens and 5 cockerels. So, I don't know about these ones, because they're... What are you going to do, hey? Should I sit with you for a minute? Sometimes you can tell by the coloring. The white ones are harder to tell. So... on the colored ones, you look for a telltale, like, very reddish kind of... And if they're speckly at their chest, like up to their neck, it's usually a girl. But the white ones are, you know, you can't really tell so easily. With the other group, and I expect with this one, some are the white, some are, and they're mixed, of course. But some of them have the silky feathers. So some of them are the white, and then they have just the normal feathers. There's no barrier, you don't need to fly. But they're all happy, actually, when they pop fly. And they were popping, like, in the morning when you see them, they're in the little brooder and they're like, pop. They're probably, like, 2 or 3 days past the time that they, you know. Oh, they're so happy. Because they were, like, kind of bouncing off the top. But now they have, like, a huge space at the top. It's got netting. But this is what they do, is they go down and then they hop. They do these little hops. It's like a happy dance. You doing the happy dance? It's fun, isn't it, to be in a bigger place? Ooh. Anyways, it's fun for me too to see them in a bigger place. Wow! You're a high flyer. That's why we have the netting on top. Wow, so happy you can fly. When they get really older, like
They don't fool around with flying. They don't really fly, but if they see an open area, they will fly like a rocket straight across. Like, so you gotta watch out for. They really are good flyers. Yeah? Happy? So, oh, maybe I'll clean up some of this tomorrow because I've been working on this like all day. We've been preparing and making a place for the other ones outside. So we're kind of like it's 8 o'clock p.m. and they usually have the lights off by now to settle them down a bit. I'll do a little cleanup. I'll freshen their water and their food. Yeah, it's so fun, isn't it? Is that fun? So fun. Quail at the Urban Quail Ranch.